Which is more correct? How many people you work with? Or how many people do you work with? How many people do work with you? Or how many people work with you? What happened last night? Or what did happen last night? If you see where I'm going with this, and if this is your weak spot, stay tuned and you're going to find out. Let's look at an example. Sam met Lisa in New York 3 years ago. Sam is the doer of the action. He did the action. He met. Met is the action. Lisa is the receiver of the action. Sam met Lisa in New York 3 years ago. As you well know, in questions, we put an auxiliary verb before the doer of the action, before the subject. The auxiliary verb of simple past is did. So, to ask a question, we put did before the doer of the action, before Sam, in any kind of question. Did Sam meet Lisa in New York 3 years ago? Where did Sam meet Lisa 3 years ago? When did Sam meet Lisa in New York? Who did Sam meet 3 years ago? In all these questions, we know who the doer of the action is. We have Sam in every question. In one example, we asked where he met Lisa. In another example, we asked when he met Lisa. In another example, we asked who he met. But we have the doer, Sam, and the action, met, in all questions. But what if we don't know the doer of the action? What if we don't know who met Lisa and we ask about it? Where should we put the auxiliary verb did if we don't have the doer, the subject, in the sentence? In case we don't know the doer, we don't put auxiliary verbs do, does, or did at all. So the right question would be, who met Lisa in New York 3 years ago? The doer is unknown. We don't put did. And the verb met should obviously be in the past form. Who met Lisa? Another example. 7 people work with Jack on the same team. As it is simple present, our auxiliary verb is do or does, which we put before the doer, before the subject. In this case, the doer is 7 people. Let's ask questions. Do 7 people work with Jack on the same team? Where do 7 people work with Jack? Who do 7 people work with? In all these examples, we know who the doer of the action is. 7 people. And what action do they do? They work. 7 people work. And if we don't know the doer, if we don't have those 7 people in the question, we don't use the auxiliary verb do. Who works with Jack? Who is singular, like he, she, or it? So we add s to the verb. And no auxiliary verbs, because we don't know the doer. Who works with Jack? How many people work with Jack? Again, we don't have There are 7 people in this question. We don't have the doer, so we don't use any auxiliary verbs. Where does Jack work? The doer is Jack. The doer is known, so we put does before Jack. Who works with Jack? The doer is unknown. We don't use auxiliary verbs. The same principle applies to what? For example, what do you want from me? The doer is you. The action is want. We put the auxiliary verb do before the doer, before you. What do you want from me? What happens when a student fails the exams? So here the action is happens. But who's the doer? The doer is unknown. The doer is what? And we don't use any auxiliary verbs. The snowstorm made them turn around and go home. The action is made. The doer is the snowstorm. The snowstorm made them turn around and go home. So it's a sentence in simple past. Our auxiliary verb will be did, that we have to put before the doer of the action, before the snowstorm. Did the snowstorm make them turn around and go home? What did the snowstorm do? Who did the snowstorm make to turn around and go home? But if we don't have the doer in the question, if we don't have the snowstorm, but instead of it, we have a what or another question word. We don't use any auxiliary verbs. What made them turn around and go home? What made them? Okay, it's time for a small test. What do you say? You know the drill, choose the best option. Who did you marry? What did he say that made you so frustrated? Who gave you that money? What seems to be the problem? What did you do to John? What happened to your hair? Who did you have dinner with? Okay, that's it. I hope this lesson was useful. See you in the next one. Stay tuned.